Yeah, good morning everybody. My name is Mihir Patel. I'm a chemical engineer as well as a project management professional PMP and also a TUE SUIT certified functional safety professional. With the grace of God, I have written a book on chemical engineering called Mihir's Handbook of Chemical Process Engineering. Today we will discuss a specific chapter on pumps, which is chapter number 3 in the book. Now, pumps are a very critical part of any process plant. Principally, there are two types of pumps. Centrifugal pumps and positive displacement pumps. There are other special type of pumps also, which are covered in the chapter. In our video presentation today, we'll quickly cover what exactly is there in the pumps chapter. Now, centrifugal pumps occupy almost 80-85% of the process industry usage. However, centrifugal pumps have certain drawbacks into which the positive displacement pumps fit in. For example, if you have a very small flow rate, then centrifugal pumps are not suitable. Their minimum flow rate which is available in the market, for example, are roughly around 3.64 meter cube per hour. So below that, you will not get a centrifugal pump. You will have to necessarily purchase this. So if you are looking for, let's say, half a meter cube per hour for a pilot plant, then you have to purchase a 4 meter cube per hour pump and then bypass the rest of the flow back to the suction. Also, centrifugal pumps cannot handle very huge viscosities. So there's a certain limitation for centrifugal pumps. Another drawback of centrifugal pumps is the head limitation. So where you have very high head requirements, again, centrifugal pumps are not suitable. So in this category, you have the positive displacement pumps. Now, positive displacement pumps have many types. So you have, for example, reciprocating type, in which the piston, plunger, and diaphragm pumps fit into. And you have the rotary types, for example, gear type, screw type, lobe type, vane type, then the specialized pumps like peristaltic pump, which is also called a squeegee pump, flexible tube pump basically, and you have the progressive cavity pumps. So these are the different positive displacement pumps. Now the centrifugal and positive displacement pumps each have different characteristics. For example, the centrifugal pump, you have the head versus flow characteristic curve. So there is a certain shutoff head. That is the maximum head which a pump will develop. And otherwise, you have the end of curve flow rate, Q, for a centrifugal pump. Whereas in a positive displacement pump, you have to be very careful because the pump will keep on pumping and increasing the pressure until either the safety valve on the discharge brakes opens or your pump damages. Pipeline, etc. can break. So the various methods of control of the two pumps, centrifugal type as well as the positive displacement pumps, are different. Now in the positive displacement pump, for example, again you have so many types. However, each type has pros and cons. For example, gear pumps can handle huge viscosities. However, they cannot handle solids. Whereas a progressive gravity pump I have seen in a polymer plant handle 80% solids in the latex of the polymer. Now these are as far as the pumps is concerned. Now the standards which are followed are also different. For example, in a centrifugal pump, you have API, specific API code followed. You have ANSI code also followed. Hydraulic Institute standards are there. Again, API pump is far costly than the ANSI and the Hydraulic Institute standards. However, they are more robust. Similar to that, positive displacement pumps also, you have various standards followed. Also, you have manufacturer standards available in both the types. So, for example, plastic pumps, centrifugal pumps. You have a few manufacturers who specifically follow their own standards. Similar to that, you have reciprocating pumps also. Many manufacturers have their own manufacturer standards. This pump works out cheaper than the specific pump as per API. Now, in the book, I have given a detailed section on the seal flushing plants. So, for example, in a centrifugal pumps, it is very important that the shaft which is going into the main pump has to be sealed. Otherwise, you will have leakage from that particular portion when the pump is pumping. So, you can have single mechanical seal, you can have double mechanical seal. When to use, which type is also specified. Also, the seal flushing plants, API seal flush plants are called, are many types. You can have API 11, which is the simplest plant for a single mechanical, as compared to dual mechanical tandem seals are there, which follow API 53, seal flushing plant API 53. So there you have double mechanical seals And the if you have very toxic fluids, etc., you can go with API 53. Cost also will be proportionally much more. Now there are a lot of hydraulic calculations covered in this chapter, specific to centrifugal pump, specific to reciprocating pump. Plus, I have given a lot of calculation templates which an engineer can use while calculating all these parameters. In addition to this, a lot of process data sheets are there on each category and the type of pump, which you can access in the process data sheet chapter of the book. Please kindly visit the website www.chemicalprocessengineering.com for a BHEs handbook, which will aid the process engineer in doing very practical way process engineering. Please like and subscribe to our videos. Thank you very much.